No, I tend to agree, Simone. First of all, it's great to be back on the weekend again and see both of you. I think that's absolutely right on a certain level. There are those who call themselves Aidos, Americans of African descendants of slavery, and they are questioning whether or not she's black or not. And I think at the heart of that argument and at the heart of what Donald Trump is doing is a basic misunderstanding. Donald Trump is a little bit more sinister, right? There is this understanding of race in the United States that is very structured, that goes back to the one drop rule. There's a conflation here of racial hierarchy and ethnicity that's going on here. In so many ways, I want to just say that this is a distraction, and it reveals not only how insidious Donald Trump is, but how dumb he is. This is a clown show on so many ways, and I don't want the campaign to get caught up in it. I want the campaign to continue to pursue its message. We're not going back, we're going forward. We don't want to go back to that mess, but those of us who have to address it, we need to address it with the seriousness of history and the seriousness of our moment, I think. But I think you're absolutely right that he's trying to appeal to those Eidos people, Simone. He absolutely is.
Meanwhile,
if it doesn't matter, I don't understand why you keep on repeating it, why the president keeps on repeating it, why those introducing the president yesterday
George,
keep on
actually,
repeating
I'm not
it.
The one who keeps repeating it. George, you're the one that's bringing it up now. That's
you've
you.
Done
I
it,
understand why
sir,
you
you've done
bring
it.
It up.
You've done it three times. Every single answer
George,
you gave me, now let me finish, sir.
George,
every single answer you gave,
me,
he repeated the
asked
slur.
Me, George. That's why I'm pushing back on you now. George, you
right,
asked me the question three times. I responded, but I'm
and
also
every
about
single
what
time
really
you repeat the
in this
slur,
election.
That is exactly my point. You simply can't say that it's wrong.
George, so then what you're saying, so then what you and I want to get off this topic because this is
yes, if someone told me that this would still be a topic of discussion, I would not believe. Recently, Biden sent this out. What really matters is the directions we take in November. The American people are struggling. Our nation needs leadership. Kamala has not proven capable. The successful Trump record of peace, prosperity, safety, and security is what America needs. Liberals like to focus on little things. Trump can say 100 things they will not pick up. Just the little they would take up and do segment over and over in it. Biden did a good job arguing with this man, trying to prove what a lot of people have been thinking that it's important. I assure you.
And you just repeated the slur again. If it doesn't matter, why do you all keep questioning her identity? She's always identified as a black woman. She is biracial. She has a Jamaican father and Indian mother. She's always identified as both. Why are you questioning that?
Well, George, first of all, this is something that's actually a conversation throughout social media right now. There are a lot of people who are trying to figure this out. But again, that's a side issue, not the main issue. The main issue.
Sir, one second. You just did it. You just did it again.
Vice President of the United States.
Why do you insist on questioning her racial identity?
You want me to talk?
I want you to answer my question.
George, now that you're done yelling at me, let me answer. He talked about it on the stage yesterday in Atlanta.
This is very important. I like the way he handled this crazy journalist. This is the same man Trump sued last time. He is trying to just portray the hatred he has toward Trump. They don't focus on important issues. They will pick up one thing out of 30, you say, oh. They focus on it. The mainstream media operate like Trump said a lot of things that day. Talk about the economy, what he would do. They will not mention that. They will always look at, oh, Trump said this. I hang on that. During that interview, I did a couple of videos. A lot of people saw what happened, how he was treated. Then crazy man like this will sit here trying to cut off the mic.
George, now that you're done yelling at me, let me answer. He talked about it on the stage yesterday in Atlanta for, what, 2 minutes? He spent more than 35, 40 minutes going after her record, talking about how radical of a senator that she was. She was the most liberal senator in the United States, in the United States Senate. That is a fact. He talked about the job that she did as vice president of the United States, a job, I will add, which has been a failure for the American people. I know you guys like to glom on to this that he talks about in jest or in a serious manner for about a minute or so, but what you do not cover is the litany of failures of Kamala Harris. That's what you're not covering, George.
So questioning somebody's racial identity for a couple of minutes is okay?
George, I'm going to tell you again, he brought it up. AP is the one that wrote the headline when she first came in to the United States Senate. Didn't talk about her being black, talked about her being the first Indian American senator. AP brought that up. I mean, George, we could have this conversation for the entire segment, but none of this matters to the American people. What matters to the American people is, are we going to have the same policies of the Biden-Harris administration that has been destructive of the American people, or are we going to have the policies of the Trump administration, which put America first, had low inflation, prosperous Americans, no matter your race, no matter your color, no matter your creed, and a foreign policy that kept America safe? Those are the facts that truly matter, because this issue is going to come and go. The lives of the American people is what's going to remain, and that's what matters more than anything else.
If it doesn't matter, I don't understand why you keep on repeating it, why the president keeps on repeating it.
This is my problem with the mainstream media. Yesterday, I saw a segment CNN put out interviewing Babas, what they think pertaining to that comment Trump made. It is everywhere. Every person has been doing that. I know a lot of people who questioned her. Then it came out, oh, she is from this direction. That does not matter. What people should focus on should be what she has done for the past years and what she is willing to do. They are not calling her up for interviews to see her reactions. Nobody is saying anything. She is not ready to talk. They are hiding her the same way they did to Biden in 2020.
Those introducing the president yesterday,
George,
keep
actually,
on repeating
I'm not
it.
The one who keeps repeating it. George, you're the one that's bringing it up now. That's
you've
you.
Done
I
it,
understand why
sir,
you
you've done
it
up. You've done it three George, times. Every single answer
George,
you gave me. Now let me finish, sir.
George,
every single you answer you gave,
you
repeated
you
the slur.
You asked me, George. That's why I'm pushing back on you now. George, you
right,
asked
and,
me the question three times. I responded, but I'm
and every single time you repeat the slur, that is my, exactly my point. You simply can't say that it's wrong.
George, so then what you're saying, so then what you, and I want to get off this topic because this is not the only thing that's going on. But George, now you're saying that AP is the one that slurred Kamala Harris, because those are the facts. You can go to the internet and look at the clips, George, if you want to, or we can talk about this now. I prefer to talk about the future of our country, because the American people are struggling. The American people do need serious policy decisions to be made, and they need serious leadership on the world stage. Kamala Harris has not proven that she can do that. Donald J. Trump has proven that he can do that.
AP did not say that Kamala Harris is not black. She is biracial. She is Indian. She is black. You continue to repeat the fact that you continue to repeat the slur. I don't understand why you and the president do it, but it's clear you're not going to say that it's wrong. I mean, you've now established.
I'm extremely happy that Trump refused to debate her on this network. ABC would do like this. Trump should not. She should debate on Fox News. Last time they came with CNN, he accepted. They should be able to do that on Fox News too.
Him to step aside.
Yeah. In this country. And the sense.
Look, three phone calls.
Abe, what can I say? Right at the top, I think I respect Kamala Harris. I have to respect this sort of greatness when you see it.